Hello everybody around the world, welcome to another episode of Dark Matter 1801. Today's episode is going to be about the infinity sign. What is an infinity sign? Well, an infinity sign looks very similar to the number 8. So it's used in love, it's used in strength. It means that life is limitless, that there's limitless possibility, that life is infinite, that anything basically is possible. It's a mathematical sign. Various companies are currently using the infinity sign, which includes Audi, Virgin Media, Facebook Meta, Fujitsu, Bitcoin, which is infinity divided by 21 million gives you an infinite number of Bitcoin. We have Boomerang, the cable TV company, Alpha Infinity, Microsoft Visual Studio, even our DNA strand also has the infinity sign figure eight. And finally, Qatar 2022 is also using the infinity sign. Now we know what the infinity sign is, we now need to find out who actually invented the infinity sign. So we're told that the infinity sign was invented by John Wallis, who is a mathematician, an English mathematician. He apparently is meant to have invented the infinity sign in 1655. There are also reports that a Greek mathematician and philosopher originally called the infinity sign the ribbon, which is kind of like a figure eight, kind of like a snake biting its tail, which means death and rebirth. You can also see in a tarot card of Pamela Colman, she's got the infinity sign floating above her head. Saint Boniface, who is supposed to be a 8th century monk from England, who also introduced Christianity into Germany. He's also supposed to have used the infinity symbol to wrap around his Latin cross. However, on close examination, when we looked at his picture again, you can actually see him putting his sword through a Bible. So I'm not going to go any further, but you can make your own conclusion on that picture. On the next picture, you can also see Saint Boniface also reading a Bible, which looks like a printed Bible. I mean, this comes across as very, very funny when we first saw this specific picture, because the printing press, actually the printing of books, wasn't even invented until the 13th century. But yet we can see Saint Boniface reading a printed Bible, which is supposed to have been in the 8th century. So you can make your own conclusion on that issue. None of the people previously mentioned in this video invented the infinity sign, because we're going to tell you for the first time who actually invented the infinity sign. So we begin with the 5th pharaoh of the first dynasty, called Pharaoh Shepataki, as we found out in our previous episode. He is the first pharaoh, as we would like to emphasize, to wear the Egyptian double crown, which is the unification of Lower Egypt and Upper Egypt. Also, we found out that his name, Din, is actually not correct, and his proper name is De, which means to arrive. So we just wanted to clarify that situation before we go any further. So here on the screen, you can see Pharaoh De, or Pharaoh Shepataki, as is known, first sitting on his throne. So you can see him quite clearly. Then he gets off his throne and you can then see him almost like running. Between him running, there's actually three symbols. Those three symbols means meta, which means three. So we just want to emphasize that Pharaoh Day or Pharaoh Shepataki, he is also a number 33. Also, in the next section, you can actually see quite clearly his solar ship, which is actually the first drawing of a solar ship in history. And then you can then see him almost throwing his enemy into the water. So you can see him quite clearly in that symbol. I mean, 33 will emphasize that in another video, but we just want to emphasize that he is a 33, and that 33 doesn't necessarily mean the 33 degree Mason. So absolutely got nothing to do with 33 degree fraudulent Mason. So Pharaoh Shepataki don't have anything to do with that, but we'll bring out another video on what 33 means and what it actually represents. Pharaoh Day or Pharaoh Shepataki also is the first mathematician in history, as he was the one who invented the symbol ka, which means counting. If you look to the left hand side, you can actually see the ka symbol of Pharaoh Shepataki. When we checked the Oxford Dictionary for the meaning of ka, this is what it reads. In ancient Egypt, the supposed spiritual part of an individual human being or god which survived in the soul after death and could reside in a statue or a person. We believe this is not the case because, as we found, ka equals count in ancient Egyptian language. If you look at the cartouche very closely, as we found in our previous episode, you can actually see clearly that the ka symbol is being omitted from the Abydos king list. You can clearly see it here, it's actually been chiseled out, so it's clear. And in the next picture, you can also see fifth on the roll, that the ka symbol is actually missing from the cartouche. If you look at the Abydos king list, you can see the ka symbol, which has been represented in the cartouche, all over from the sixth or seventh king right through to the 67th king. So we find the ka symbol not only in the first dynasty of Egypt, but we find it right through to the 26th dynasty of Egypt. This is why we know for certain that the ancient Egyptian hieroglyphs and the language is 100% Yoruba. It's there for everybody to see. Long after Pharaoh Shepataki's death, you can still see the symbol ka being displayed everywhere. For example, you can see it on the walls of Egypt, even 1,500 years after the Pharaoh's death. They also had a temple actually dedicated to him, called the Temple of Ka. Back during ancient Egyptian times, the high priest, known as Inuka, which means to count from inside, used to charge the citizens to count. So they used to come to the high priest, they used to bring their goods, but the high priest wouldn't count on the outside because they didn't want to give out their secrets. So they used to count on the inside and then give their citizens or customers those information. This is how they made their money back in those days. The hieroglyph for Ika, the name Ika, the Egyptian god of magic and medicine, was written by the ancient Egyptians in the following hieroglyphs. There seems to be some misinterpretation of this symbol, but to clarify the first hieroglyph picture, a wick which was the symbol used for the letter H, the two upraised arm is the symbol for the word ka. Now, that statement that I just read out is actually completely wrong, because the word ika actually comes from ka. Ika basically means a person who is wicked in ancient Egypt. And the reason why the population or the citizens of ancient Egypt used ika was because the priests were charging them too much money for them to count their goods, because the priests during the time were counting inside and they were not counting outside. So the priests didn't want the population to know their secret. So the population now started calling the priests wicked or ika. So that's where ika actually comes from, meaning that you refuse to count outside, you're actually counting on the inside. That's what it means. So the statement that I've just read out is not true. Now this brings us finally to the question, who invented the infinity sign? Well, we can tell you in this channel for the first time that the infinity sign was invented by the fifth king or pharaoh of the first dynasty, called Day or Pharaoh Shikpataki. And you can see it quite clearly in his sign here. This is the first infinity sign symbol in history. And he's also the first mathematician in history. And his legacy is actually being lost. This brings us to the end of this episode. Please do like, share, and subscribe. We end this episode in this fashion. To know God is to know yourself. So now that we black people know exactly who we are, which is the fact that we are the descendants of the ancient Egyptian, right through from the first dynasty of Egypt, right through to the 26th dynasty of Egypt, it's important to know exactly where we come from, which is our history, because that way we know exactly where we're going. So for the Europeans or the Eurocentric and the Arabs, they can still continue to keep their delusional thinking, whether it's the fact that the ancient Egyptians are aliens or the alien race. They can continue to keep that illusion. We know exactly who we are, and that is giving us a huge confidence going into 2022. So therefore, Pharaoh D or Pharaoh Shikpataki is infinity. Goodbye.